guys, it's Jamira from RC Militia, doing something a little bit different. I'm going to show you guys how it is that I paint with puffy paint. If you guys are part of the RC Militia Facebook group page, then you've seen step by step the process of this Secure D4 body. The video of the unboxing is the one right before this video. Jeremy's in charge of building the car, I'm just in charge of painting the body. So you guys have seen Boba Fett, Stormtrooper, Emperor, Darth Maul, Darth Vader, Imperial Guard, TIE Fighter, and Jabba the Hutt all come to life through the Facebook page. If you're not a part of it, then hey, you know, you're missing out, because I actually took a poll on what I should put right here, and a lot of you guys said Jabba the Hutt. I went with it, so this is all you guys. You guys designed that part of it, and if you're not a part of the Facebook page, then you had no help in it. But yeah, go ahead, jump on there, check it out. I'm gonna be painting bodies off and on. I got some family stuff going on, but I'm still gonna make some time for painting. And I'll throw up any paint jobs that I do, I'll throw them up on there so you guys get to see them first before they go on any video of any sort. But not all of them will be a tutorial like this one's gonna be. I'm gonna finish off this body, the main part, with a tutorial on how to do the Imperial symbol. So that's gonna go right on top of the roof. Kind of blends everything together. It's a bad guy car, so that's why the Imperial symbol. I wanted to keep it kind of more basic and simple so you guys can see first video kind of something that's not super complicated but has a couple techniques that that you guys would be able to use on your own if you want to try this out. So this body is ready to go. All right, switch the camera around so you guys can see over my shoulder and watch me do it. All right guys, so I have the image taped to the backside, and you always want to try to figure out what's the best way to approach it. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay down the white, and then I'm going to stick that in front of the little fan that I have. It's going to dry it a lot faster. And then I can come back and I can do all the details of the red and blending the red into the black and stuff. But I just kind of want to get the white out of the way. Sometimes you have to let them dry in stages so that you make sure you don't mess anything up. When it's such fine lines like this, you really want to make sure that that they are very pronounced. When they're images like Jabba the Hutt or something like that, you don't have to worry about that as much, but this is an iconic symbol and it's very straight pronounced lines. So you don't want to mess that up trying to blend black in when your white's not dry. I'm going to put the white using the bottle, which you only want to do that in larger areas. If they were little tiny little areas, then I would place it on my little paper towel over here, and then I would use a needle and I would transfer it that way. But since it's quite thicker, I'm just gonna lay it down with the bottle, and then I'm going to move it around with the needle. So I'll fast forward through all of it so you guys can see me doing it. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see white on top of white, but I'll just follow me with this, okay guys? So you don't want to do lay down too much puffy paint at once, because it does dry rather quickly, and it starts like pudding gets that film on the top. Once it starts to do that, it's going to be rather hard to kind of blend it and move it, because it just isn't as smooth, and you can't get it into the areas so you can get the nice clean corners and stuff like that. So I'm just going to do a couple little sections at a time. And then once the white's done, then I'll dry it, and then you guys won't have to wait for that. I'll come right back. We'll be right back.
Alright guys, so you can see that I'm moving the body back and forth. Why this is because with the needle, when you're going up against a straight line that you're trying to get, you're wanting the needle to go towards that line. If I'm trying to drag it behind, I'm not gonna be able to get a straight line. That's just not how it works. So I'm gonna, wanting to get this right side line, I'm gonna turn the body around so I'm angled, you know, the point of the needle is pointed towards the straight line that I'm trying to create. So never try to create a line going backwards. I mean, well, you can, but it's not gonna be nearly as straight as what you'll be able to get going forward. So that's just a little helpful hint that I learned the hard way over the years. So you guys get all these tidbits for free and you don't have to make all the mistakes that I've done. Don't want to lay down too much paint in an area like this because you're just going to spread it out with the needle anyway. So don't worry too much about having to fill in the whole thing. Okay guys, here's a good time to show you how to fix something. So if you look at this line right here, maybe it's not crazy visible, but the white went a little too far in for my taste. So the line's a little too thick. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work on these other ones and I'm gonna come back to this, and that will give it time to kind of create that film that I'm talking about. And then once that does, I'm gonna use that to my advantage to kind of push back the paint and create that more open look, especially kind of right through here is what I'm gonna do. So I'll show you guys when I do that after I finish these last three sections. So I'm not grabbing lots at a time. I'm literally, it may look like I'm not doing anything, but I can see that the line is getting further back because it's a little bit dry on the edges. So I'm pushing the paint back to where I want it to be. And if you get a little bit too far in where it's still a little bit wet, then wipe your needle off on your paper towel that you got off to the side, and then go back at it. So I cleaned up that section, so now I'm on to this section. And a big part I learned this so many times the hard way. Watch your hand, because it is so easy to dunk your hand into wet paint and then you smudge it all over. I have ruined so many things. Jeremy can contest that it'll drive you nuts. You work so hard and then you smudge it with your finger. It drives you nuts. So be very mindful of where any other digits that aren't doing anything are at all times. And now that I say that, I'll probably dunk them in here, but hopefully not. Wow, yeah, okay. So this is not planned. All right, guys, see the white on my finger right there? Literally just told you not to do something and then I went ahead and did it. Luckily it was right in there. I already had to fix that spot, but don't do what I just did. Be mindful of your digits, Tamara. So yeah, I'm gonna try to take my own advice here. So I'm gonna go ahead and let this dry, and then once it does, then I'll come back and I'll do the little black and red kind of mixture and I'll show you how I do that. Alright guys, so this is the little setup that I have. The cereal boxes are there because I was drying something else and I needed them to kind of like hold it up. But this is what I'm doing. It's right next to a sink right here, so I just grabbed the soap and held the body down on one side, and here's a little fan right here. Just gonna blow it at the puffy paint, because one wonderful thing about puffy paint is it does not streak. Like, if you can hold it upside down, it's not gonna drip off. You can hold it sideways, it's not gonna fall down. Once you put it on, it stays where it's at, so I can have it sideways and dry it. And so this fan is wonderful. Turn it on and it will dry 10 times faster than if I just let it air dry, so. All right, now we're gonna do something that a little more tricky, not super bad. What it is you guys can see how there's red on the outside, like a half a halo, I don't know, on each side, and then little bits on the inside. Well, and then there's black, so it's all blended together. You could be really harsh with your lines and kind of put red where the red is, and then put the wait for that to dry and then do the black. And I used to do that, but I'm finding that blending it just comes out so much cooler. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my bottle of red, and this is a deep red, and I am going to lay down some red right where the red main, like, kind of focus where the red is really coming off bright. So I'm gonna run that a kind of a line all the way through the little parts. All right, then I'm gonna take my black, and it's a lot stronger up here, maybe a tiny bit of red up here. We're gonna be blending this out, so really this red up here is just gonna supply kind of a slight red hue, which is what we've got going on. You're not gonna see that red like you will with the other parts. So I'm gonna do this part first up top, and normally I wouldn't say to lay down this paint, but I kind of got sidetracked. So when we put down some black over the top of it, don't worry about if it gets on the white, because you're not going to get anything underneath that white. The white is where the white is. You're not gonna get underneath it, so don't worry about going over it or anything like that. You don't have to stay inside the lines, which is wonderful right now. So I laid black over the red. Now I'm just going to take the tip of the puffy paint, because the needle's a little too fine, and I'm just gonna blend this and keep kind of rubbing it in. And I'm gonna push the black over there, push the black over here, but I'm gonna really concentrate on the center part, because I know that the red is in there. And I really want to make sure that the red kind of gets out, that it's not bright red in any areas when we flip this over. So I'm gonna just kind of keep blending. Right now you're not really seeing what you're doing. I could flip over the body, take off the back little part, and I'll do that in just a second. But I want to blend for a little bit, and then I'm gonna focus down here, then I'll check it out from behind, and kind of, I'll show you how I do it once I flip it over. So with these, we want the red to be focused on the middle part. So I'm gonna kind of bring this black out here. So where kind of more is black dominant, I have a little string in there. Where it's more black dominant, I'm gonna leave that out here. There we go. Might add a little more red, just because we're gonna be blending so much that you're not gonna see nearly as much red as you're seeing on here. It's not gonna be as bold and thick. So I'm kind of pushing the black where it's more black dominant and kind of staying away from where I can see the red at. All right, now we're gonna get into the red. I'm gonna pull the black towards the red, all right? And I can do a little black around this ring right here. Do a little ring right here. All right, now we're gonna start to blend. I'm gonna drag this red to wherever I want it. I know there's a little in there, there's a little in there, there's a little in there, and some in there. But really, the main focus is right through here where it's really strongly red. So I'm gonna take the black and I'm gonna blend it with the red. Just kind of rubbing the tip of the puffy paint bottle through it. So make sure that every spot's covered. And after I do this a little bit, I'm gonna flip it over, take off the piece of paper that has the image on it, and then I'm gonna look from that side, and that's gonna show me the main part. So let me finish up this side before I do. Add a little bit of red in here. A little bit of red. Some black. I don't have to worry about that puff on the white because it doesn't matter at this point. Like I said, you don't have to worry about staying inside the lines right now because we let it dry. Now, if we wouldn't have taken the time to let it dry and this was wet white paint, we would be so screwed right now. We would have messed up everything that we worked hard to do with our clean lines and stuff. All right, so let me take off this back part. Now, this is where the fun part comes in. I'm gonna flip it over. Looks really cool, huh, guys? But that's not really what the image looks like. It's blended more. So you'll have the image and what we got going on. So I want, okay. So you can see the puffy paint tip or whatever underneath it. That's what's really nice about the clear bodies. So I'm gonna come over here where it was red dominant, and I'm gonna get in there and kind of work out those brighter red spots, both sides. Cause I kind of just want the red hint a little bit there, kind of like a dark, dark burgundy, but not a solid red like some of the spots are. Now when it comes into here, I'm gonna make it so that the spots are more touch up so they all go out and fill right to the white line. And now, once I have that, now we can play with this part on the inside. So you'll be able to see, as I blend it, the paint moving, okay? So what I'm wanting to do is I'm dragging the red out. It takes a bit of blending in order to completely mesh the two together. So don't worry so much about touching the red and thinking, oh, instantly it turns black. That's you know, if that's what you're blending with, that's not what's gonna happen. All right. Kind of blend out this side a little bit more because that side's not as red. Just bring the red a little bit further over here. See how I'm bringing the red even closer in? Because you can move it. That's what's really, really cool. But it's like a DQ blizzard. Once you put it where you want it, you don't have to worry about it moving at all. That's what's really nice. You can put it upside down and it doesn't go anywhere. All right, so I'm gonna push this red to the front a little bit more. I want a little bit more red in there. It's not really easy to do once you already have black in there or whatever, but it is possible. So, gotta find where the tip of the puffy paint is, and then you just go to town with blending again. All right, so now we're gonna go out to these outsides. You see, you gotta keep the red more prominent in the middle. Over here, more prominent in the middle. Kind of blend it out a little bit into the black. All right, so you guys can see how it's, well, we got the glare on it. Okay, there we go, not as glary. All right, it's obviously not gonna be exactly perfect like the image. That's never gonna happen. So you're gonna have to decide on what your best is. And whatever your best is, that's great. All right, now that you have the blended on the inside, we're gonna go ahead and put this back over. Don't push it down yet because you wanna make sure that it lines up where you're at. It has a tendency to kind of lose its place. And now, what we did on the inside, we're just gonna do that on the outside. So, you can see that the red is a lot stronger right through here. So I'm gonna lay down a bit of heavier red right through here and get a little bit smaller out to there. And then I'm gonna do the black, and then I'm gonna do the other side. Just cause I don't want one side drying and all that. So I'm gonna do one side, then the other. My edges don't have to be perfect on this extra part right through here, but when it comes around the windows, you don't wanna, you know, those are your windows, you don't wanna cover them up, so be more mindful of those. I'll probably get them close enough, and then I'll go through and touch it up later, so you guys don't have to sit while I'm trying to do all that. Now that I have the center pretty red like I want, I'm gonna blend out these edges a lot more. So it doesn't just kinda go red to black. It's gonna kinda go red to maroonish, dark, dark maroonish to black. You guys can see that it's not gonna be, like I said, it's not gonna be the exact same thing, but it's the general idea. It's your own interpretation of it. I could show you the images I did of all these guys, and none of them look exactly the same. It's not how it works. This is computerized. This is done by hand. It's just gonna be different. But I like the look of this. I feel like it's a lot cooler than just an imperial sign. So I'm gonna do the exact same other side really quick. I'll fast forward it for you, and then I'll show you the finished product. Now let me welcome everybody to the Wild Wild West. Until I see the sun. All right, guys, so there's the two sides. Blended out the other one just like I did the first one that I showed you. We tried to take this glare off of it a little bit. I don't know if that helps you at all. But it just kind of spices up an imperial sign. It will be a whole lot glossier and pretty once I take this protective film off. And I don't have all the windows completely perfect, you know, the trim and stuff like that, because since I'm not using any rattle can paint or anything like that on this body, I'm gonna make my own trim underneath, and so I'm not super worried about laying down any of the window masking or anything like that. So that's why there's none on there. I could have, but then if I got puffy paint over it, then I would have to worry about, you know, that getting peeled and this and that. And so I just didn't do it, and I'll just clean up the windows and clean up all the lines and stuff like that a little bit later. But that was just a quick tutorial on how it is that I'm doing what I'm doing. This is a very kind of basic idea, and once you kind of apply these principles over and over and over again, it becomes second nature, and you don't really even think about why you're doing what you're doing. And then you'll start whipping out, you know, Boba Fett's and stuff like that, and it will all make sense why you're doing what you're doing. And so I really like the top of this, loving the design with the red kind of going through it. Fits with like my Imperial Guard and my Darth Maul and stuff. I really, really love the look of it. So I'm very glad that I did it. I'm so glad that you guys got to see. So I really appreciate if you guys watch the entire tutorial. I hope it's not too long. I try to fast forward as much as possible. But yeah, if you guys learned something, that's awesome. That's the best thing. If you guys have any questions, by all means, please put your questions down below. I will answer every single one of them. One question that I've been getting is, can you make me a body? Can you paint me a body? And I really appreciate those. Don't get me wrong, guys. But right now, I'm painting on my off time because I have a lot going on with a certain family member that I'm going to be taking care of and helping a lot. And so that's going to be my prime focus. And painting is going to be kind of secondary. Because family comes first, guys. But I still will be painting. Everyone needs to do some stuff in their downtime. And I'm not taking any requests right now. I've had a lot of requests. And I, like I said, I really appreciate that, guys. But you guys did give me some good ideas. Some Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles bodies, stuff like that. Maybe some Avengers bodies. But keep the ideas coming. If you guys have, say, hey, you know, have you ever thought about doing this or blending this way or something like that? I would love to hear it. I mean, a lot of things I learn are all because I messed up and it came out cool, or I messed up and I learned I don't do that anymore. So this is the kind of easier step, and I will kind of apply every tutorial something more and more and more, so that you guys will kind of start to see all the different techniques that I'm doing. But yeah, that's kind of the basics, guys. I thank you so much for watching, and yep, like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. So once again, I'm Jamara from RC Militia. I really appreciate you guys sticking through this, and hope you enjoyed.